completed 2 days in the new Bulgarian university. Which courses did you do?
I've been here a total of 4 days.
Okay.
And the first 2 days was on the Serdev suture thread lift. Mm-hmm. Then after that was on laser liposuction. Mm-hmm. And liposelection. And then today was on rhinoplasty. Mm-hmm.
And do you use this yourself?
Yes, yes, I do.
You do, okay. And have you done any rhinoplasties in the past?
I have not done rhinoplasty. Mm-hmm. But after today, I will be starting to do it.
Okay. And what did you learn today about rhinoplasty that would make you want to begin to do it?
I learned that how easy it could be if it is if the process is looked at very logically. You're working with soft tissue with cartilage, and by cutting off little bits of cartilage using Dr. Serdev's method, you really get a beautiful nose.
Okay. And do you see patients that would require this in your practice?
I see quite a few patients who would like to get a better looking nose. And now I will be able to add this to my practice, and my patients will be more happy.
Okay, regarding the basal treatments, what did you learn during your period in Bulgaria?
I learned it is always nice to observe people who are very experienced in this, like Dr. Like Professor Serdev, and I learned how he uses the razor, and I liked the technique he uses.
Okay. We discovered yesterday a couple of different things regarding the technique. What did you notice, for instance, was the difference between the superficial and the deeper layers of fat regarding vaser?
Well, what is very interesting about a vaser is that it targets the larger fat cells, which are more in the deeper layer of the fat. And in the superficial layer, we have cells which are smaller. So vaser will selectively lyse the cells, break the cells, which are in the deeper layer, so you end up with a smoother finish and a tighter skin.
Okay, at one stage yesterday you said, oh, this is eureka moment for me. What did you mean by that exactly?
Well, it was exactly finding out how the selective vaser is for the larger fat cells. And knowing that the larger fat cells are in the deeper layer, the process of a vaser was very clear.
Okay, do you mean selective against smaller fat cells or against other types of cells, like
against smaller fat cells and also other cells which are there, such as you have the lymphatic system, you have other systems which are present, and this the vaser selectively goes after the larger fat cells, leaving the architect intact, such as the nerves, the blood vessels, the fibrous tissue. And since the architect is left intact, you get a very nice, smooth result on the skin.
Okay, and can you tell us what way, in practical terms, this could be an advantage to your client?
For my clients, for the appropriate population, it'll be a process which is faster. The recovery time is going to be much faster for them. They can return to work sooner. And overall, the pain which they feel will be much better. And also, the blood loss is significantly less.
Okay, so you're really saying, in effect, that if you can selectively target fat cells against blood vessels or nerve, then obviously the patients will get less bruising and also they'll have less pain.
Absolutely.
Okay. Bringing you to the first part of your course regarding the Serdev sutures, in what way was this different than other suturing techniques that you've learned in the past?
I have not learned other techniques. This is the first technique I'm learning. I had trained with another doctor who had trained with Dr. Serdev. And so I came directly to Dr. Serdev to learn his technique, and I was extremely impressed.
Okay, and most of the suturing techniques are regarding fixation of movable structures onto immovable structures. And as a consequence of this, we notice that there's certain places in the face, for instance, that can be pulled back to make people look younger. Do you think you will use this in your practice?
I will be using it immediately. I will be doing a couple of cases this weekend. I can't wait to use this technique. I am doing some techniques on the patients, such as the butt lift, by using the Serdev method, and I'm getting very good results with it. But I'll be adding more techniques in my armamentum to give a wide variety of choices for my patients.
Some people say that you should never practice on your nurses or your receptionist until you're fully sure of what you're doing, because if you make a mistake, the whole world can see it. What do you think about that?
Well, I don't think I'm going to make a mistake, because I have learnt and I learnt my techniques so well, and Dr. Serdev has taught me well. I really don't expect to make a mistake, and I will of course take it slow.
Okay. Regarding the rhinoplasty course that you have done today, what do you think you've learned to bring back to America?
I am a gynecologist by training, and I have learned how simple rhinoplasty can be. I still need a little bit more experience in this before I will start offering it to my patients. But I think it is a very extremely nice technique. We did a case just a few minutes ago, and right after the case was done, the patient looked at herself in the mirror, and she was extremely happy with the result, and she walked out of here. And there was really no evidence that she had rhinoplasty. There were no bandages, there was no tapes, no visible sutures on the outside. It was really nice.
And the patient actually cried, if I remember right.
Yeah, the patient kept crying because she was so very happy about the procedure. She had wanted a better nose for all her life, and she saw that she has a nose which she wanted in a few minutes, she was unbelievably happy, and she couldn't stop crying.
Would you use this on trauma patients?
I don't have experience with trauma patients, but I think it can be modified for trauma patients.
Okay, if somebody came into you, for instance, after a car crash with a septal deviation, would you see this as being an appropriate means of treatment?
If it is in the cartilage, soft cartilage, which is towards the front of the nose, then yes. If there is a damage...
By referral to an ENT surgeon first to allow the septum deviation to heal?
Yeah, the septum deviation, if there is a deviation to the septum, it has to be corrected before you correct the soft tissue and the cartilage.
Okay, and what sort of time period do you think should pass before you would go ahead to try and sort of correct the aesthetic deformity?
First you need to correct the structural deformity. Mm-hmm. And that'll be done by an ENT doctor. Mm-hmm. And then you go to wait about 6 months, mm-hmm. and then you correct the cosmetic deformity, and then together you get a very nice, pleasing aesthetic result.
Okay. Thank you.
Thanks.